As America leaves Afghanistan, there remains the possibility of a humanitarian disaster. Feeding millions of people is a top priority of the United Nations World Food Program. Its director is David Beasley, who negotiated with Taliban leaders in Qatar last week over the continuation of aid. Earlier today, our Amna Nawaz spoke with him from his home in South Carolina.
David Beasley, welcome back to the NewsHour. Thank you again for making the time. I have to ask you, today is the very first day of Taliban rule across Afghanistan. You met with the Taliban last week in Doha. What did you agree to with respect to World Food Program's continuing work in the country?
You know, it's been an interesting time because the Taliban have been assuring us that they want us to continue. I met with them and said, let's be very clear. We need our independence, impartiality, neutrality, and they've assured us of that. And so in the areas that they have gained control over the last few weeks, they have, in fact, assured us, protected our warehouses, made certain that we can operate independently. They've done that so far. They've honored their word. We've had very frank discussions about the needs. Please don't get in the way of our helping the innocent victims of conflict, the people that are in need. And quite frankly, so far, shockingly, too many people, they have done that. And we're working through many issues as we speak, like our national women that work with us, school meals programs for little girls. They're assuring us that we will be able to continue to do that. And so far they have, but they are actually putting their people into place now, and particularly in the provinces. This is, you know, Kabul is a small part of the issue. It's the rest of the country where we have our massive operations. And of course, this fall, we're very concerned because we're running out of money. The winter months are coming and we've got to pre-position food, but that's another discussion.
Well, let me ask you about what they've been saying to you so far, what you've been seeing so far in the early days, and what's ahead, because this is the big question. There is a very big gap between the messaging we're hearing from the leadership now and their actual record. Horrific abuses against minorities, not allowing girls into public spaces, oppression of women. If those practices pick up, what can you do? Can you withhold aid? Can you not work with them?
No, you're exactly right. And, you know, the more they cooperate, the better it is for everybody. So far, we've received the cooperation, but again, we're just now getting out into the weeds, so to speak, throughout the country. Operations so far are so good. We've had a couple, hiccups, but that's normal, and they've corrected them quickly. For example, they're not taxing our trucks. They're allowing us the access. We're now moving people back out into the field. Operations are starting again. And so, as I've told them, I said, I will speak the truth. If you become a problem, I will tell the world so. So please cooperate with us. We are here to help the innocent people of Afghanistan. And so we're working through a lot of issues right now. And actually, in a couple places, we've had the Taliban say, give them a little bit of time to get their act together, which is actually not surprising because they're putting their teams into place. They've got a new government they're designing, putting together. But I hope that we can get all that resolved so that we can get about our business to reach the people in need so they don't become vulnerable to ISIS and Al-Qaeda and, you know, life and death situations.
So this is a new government that's come in. They have inherited a budget that was essentially 75% dependent on international aid, right? And we know billions of dollars from the U.S., from the IMF, from others have been frozen. Based on your impression of the Taliban so far, based on the promises you've been made and what you've seen, do you think that those leaders, as you have, should trust the Taliban, that they're building an inclusive, different government to the one they had before, and release those funds?
You know, this is the dilemma, the paradox, is that what's your alternative? If you're not careful, you could have something a lot worse. And so the reality going forward, you've got moderate Taliban, you got hardliners. And if we're not careful, then if we allow the extremists to take over, then everybody loses. So we don't have a choice. I mean, we just can't walk away and say, oh, we don't care. People can't go without food for a month. They just can't do that. And so we've got to work with whomever's in charge. And while we're doing that, we want to do everything we can to help stabilize and build a path forward. Some of the areas that we're already getting a very positive operations moving forward in Taliban-controlled areas, but there's some other areas that are more hardliners. So we're sitting down, explaining what we're doing, why we're doing it, how we will do it. We want to reach women and men. We want to reach girls and boys. And so far, so good. But let's see. We've got 14 million people right now marching towards starvation. And we can't turn our back on them. And if we do, then you've created an incredible opportunity for extremist groups to exploit and recruit. And we've seen what happened in Syria. We've seen it happen in other places around the world when we've turned our back on innocent people. They've become, obviously, victims to using food as a weapon of recruitment for war. We don't want that.
If they do continue to restrict women's movement, as we've seen, if they do go back to their ways of oppressing minorities, committing horrific abuses against them, you're saying you'll continue to deliver aid because you have no choice? So why would they act differently then?
Well, I think what we're being told so far with our women working with WFP, we evaluate all of these different dynamics. It's so far so good. I can imagine there will be some difficult areas. We've got to work through those, and we want to obviously food to be used in a humanitarian way. Where there's going to be complications, obviously we're going to deal with it because we're not going to go in. First and foremost, we feed women and men, girls and boys. I just can't imagine that being tampered with. That would be a red line for sure.
You and your team are doing such necessary work under incredibly difficult circumstances. David Beasley, Executive Director of the World Food Program, we wish you luck ahead. Thank you so much for making the time.
Well, thank you very, very much. We're going to get it done. I can assure you that it's just, that's the World Food Program. Thank you.